the Laplace transform of this without evaluating the integral. So as you can see from the definition, we need to have the function in terms of u and the function in terms of t minus u. But in this case, we only have the function in terms of u, and we're missing the function in terms of t minus u. But actually we do, but it is hidden. So let me pull it out for you so that you can see it. Okay, so this is the function in terms of u, and here's the function in terms of t minus u. So t minus u to 0 is just 1, and 1 times this is just this, right? So now we do have the function in terms of u and t minus u, so this can be rewritten as at psi of t convoluted with 1. Okay, and don't forget the t out front. So some people may dispute this over, but it's not properly, and you cannot do that. We don't have that property. So looking at this, what we are going to do is to take apply the transform of the derivative theorem for t. So let me use a different color here. So t is negative 1 to the first times the first derivative of this, okay? Of this. So I have a psi t, which is 1 over s squared plus 1 times 1 over s. And now let me simplify this first. So I have negative first derivative of 1 over s times s squared plus 1. Now take the first derivative of this. I have negative s derivative this times this plus this times the derivative of this. So this is the derivative of a product, okay? All of this divided by the bottom squared. Okay? Now simplify this a little bit, so the negative psi becomes positive. So up here I have s squared plus 2s squared, 3s squared plus 1 over s squared, this really 2, times s squared plus 1 squared, right? So this is your final solution. Hope that makes sense.
If you find the video is helpful, feel free to give it a like, share, and subscribe to my channel in order to receive the most current videos. Don't forget to hit the bell so that you won't miss anything. I'll see you next time.